Yeah, I'm just kidding, guys. Just kidding. No second countdown. Welcome, everyone, to this team live stream of Axie Infinity. My name is Alexander, also known as Psychout. I'm one of the co-founders of Axie Infinity, and we're incredibly excited to have you guys all with us today. I can see that there are almost actually 400 people in the stream live already. That's incredible. We've never had so many people here, and this is the first stream we've had in a really, really long time. If there is anything wrong with my microphone or the sound, just let us know on Twitter, probably. Should be a good place to go. We have a lot of interesting things to talk about today, so I'm going to try to keep it short and concise, but of course, it's not only me who is here. I have Jeff with me, so I'm going to see if we can get him on the line here. I'm going to do a little bit of unmute. Maybe you need to unmute yourself, Jeff. Let's see. Are you there?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah. Everything is great. Welcome, Jeff, or G-Hos, as you are known. You want to say something to the people who are joining us today?
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be an amazing day. It's a day that we've been building towards for over 2 years now. I think it's going to be a celebration of the progress that we've made so far and a glimpse into the new era that's coming. So yeah, welcome to the stream, everybody. And I'm so excited.
Yeah, thanks, Jeff. I know that you're a little bit busy preparing various launching things that we're going to be doing today. So I'm not going to take up too much of your time. Of course, you will be joining us a little bit later in the stream. And that's also including the special guests. Oh, you even have Puff with you. And also, let's see if we have someone we want to say hi to in the stream. I know we have a lot of OGs in there. Do we want to do some shout outs? Did you see someone? I can see Olden is in here. Coco too.
I see everyone. Cuckoo. Yeah. Cuckoo's been on fire. We got Brookhawk. We got Reels. We got Enjoy. We got DeVicio. Everyone's here. Yeah. Freaks here. Everyone set their alarms. No matter where you are in the world, you woke up for this. It means a lot to me. We've always known that the Axie community is special. The world is now starting to learn what we've known for so long, and it feels amazing.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we know this is early in some places in the world. You, Jeff, you've been doing a all-nighter, I should say. Is that right?
I wasn't able to sleep. Like, I tried to sleep and I just couldn't. So I'm right there with you. I bet a lot of you guys were in the same boat as me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I happy to hear that. So I'm going to let you get back to work now. And then we're going to kind of jump back with you later. But for everyone else who's here, let's jump a little bit into a quick talk about where we are and what's going to be happening today. So here we go. That should be 4. All right. So, boom. There might have been some leaks there for those of you who were super fast. Oh, they have a little slight thing here happening. All right. So, as I said, thank you all for joining today. We're going to be unveiling a lot of cool stuff. This is, of course, the brand new Axie Infinity logo. Some of you have seen it. Some of you have not. And what we're celebrating today is pretty much what's happening within the Axie Infinity universe that we've been building for so long. And what we've seen is that how impactful it can actually be to have a game where you're utilizing play to earn to its, not full extent, but just to its very early, it's just the beginning of play to earn, so to say. But more so than that, also utilizing, giving people the true ability to actually own their game items and by extension, digital identity. So I want to talk a little bit first about what we've seen happen in actually the Philippines. So for those of you who have been paying attention to Axie, you might have seen this article already. Basically, what we've seen is the really early stages of how impactful a game can be when it actually utilizes play to earn in a nice way. So in the Philippines, there's actually an entire village who is right now living off playing Axie Infinity. So I want to give a shout out to that. And the good news is that this is just the beginning. So these guys, they have been farming small love potions and selling that. And that's already had quite an impact in that community. And that's what we've seen in Axie is that this has impacted the game growth and the trajectory too after people started realizing what's actually happening here. So right now we're actually in the middle of a parabolic growth phase. And that means that since July 6th, we've seen over 143% increase in holders of Axies. And we've actually went from about 700 weekly active users to over 7,000. And what's even greater is that the people who have been sticking around, who's maybe been holding Axies for some time, they are now coming back to play the game. So let's see if I can move my... here, so you can see that inactive players become reactivated when Axie Infinity gets more traction. So, what is happening next right now? I guess, how do we actually take this into the next level? And that's by actually introducing something brand new into the game, by allowing people to actually play to earn the governance token of Axie Infinity, which is called Axie Infinity Shards. And for that, we have something incredible, some incredible news for you all. So get ready for this one. If you guys have ever played Axie Infinity, congratulations. You are Axie Infinity Shard holders. If you own Axies still, congratulations. You are Axie Infinity Shard holders. If you own land still, you are Axie Infinity Shard holders. And if you ever interacted with our official marketplace, traded, then you are also Axie Infinity Shard holders or access holders. And we're going to get back into that a little bit in the future. More details around that. But that is not all. And now you guys have to wait a little bit longer for the real announcement.
dorime, interrimo ad appare dorime, ameno, ameno, lancire, lanciremo dorime, ameno, o manare in perra via, ameno, timere, timere, mangirò, mangiremo, ameno. Interrimo ad appare dorime, ameno, ameno, lancire, lanciremo dorime, ameno, o manare in perra via, ameno, timere, timere, mangirò, mangiremo, ameno.
Amen.
remember, guys, please retweet and share this across the world. This is an incredible moment for Axie and for all of you guys who own Axie Infinity Shards. And that, of course, is the community and us. And we're so excited to share this with you all. We've actually got 650 people in the stream live right now. It's incredible, I must say. This is insane. I remember back in the day we had 20. It's not so long ago, actually. So that's great. I think I'm also going to say it right now. We have some other stuff that has been announced. So let's jump right into it and show you guys how this is looking. So if you want to say something, Jeff, just fire away. But in the meantime, I'm going to see. Oh, we have Jan who wants to join as well. But who is that? I don't know, really. We'll see. But what I'm going to do is jump in here, and then I'm going to say that, okay, guys, if you now check axieinfinity.com, you will see, okay, well, it should be up really, really soon. We just have to wait for the final deployment. But a new website is coming out here very fast. A white paper is now also ready. A newly deployed white paper where you can check whitepaper.axieinfinity.com. And there is also an infographic with all the information that you might need about the Axie Infinity sale on Binance Launchpad. So there's a whole lot of information that you guys and girls can look into right now. But let's see if we can get this new website started up pretty soon. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Here it is.
All right. I'm firing off then.
Yes, yes, yes. Let's see. We're going to experience it together, everyone. Experiencing the new website together. Ah, it's going to take a little bit to load here. I can see that our axes are floating a little bit in the air. Do a quick refresh here. Looks like we have some news that's going to be coming out soon. In any case, if you start scrolling down here a little bit, you can see the new things on the website. So for those of you guys who have been playing Axie for some time, you will recognize some of the special art here. This one is for example, Bean's Blessing. And then you can see the new art style here, some axes, some new Axie art. And then a little bit more about the Play to Earn Revolution, the Discord, the Marketplace, the Mavis Hub. And then we have some axes here and more new art style about Axie battles and the new Axie Origin battle mode that is coming out very, very soon. Incredible new art here. And more stuff about Axie Land, of course. And we're going to be rolling out more information in the very, very short time or very, very quickly. Oh, yeah. Let's see. Here, I was almost like, oh, we haven't released this partnership yet, but we have. Binance News is up here too as well. So what's happening with you, Jeff, on your side? Are you?
Yeah, I feel amazing. I feel nervous. I have butterflies. I fired off the email and I made the Discord announcement, and I'm just about to fire off a tweet. And yeah, you know, would love everybody in the community's help spreading this. You guys are all AXS owners, so. Or access owners.
Yes, access is important that we say that.
So yeah, let's do this.
Give me a second.
We're all in this together now.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to see. Wait. Oh, there you are. There you're back. Okay. We're waiting on our special guest here, so let's see if we can get him in here too. Because he's been instrumental in the development of the new Axie Infinity Shard token. But before we start that, maybe I should actually explain it to you a little bit. For those of you who have no idea what Axie Infinity Shards are, or the implication of what they will have in the community, I'm going to do that too. But there we have our new special guest. But before that, let me see if I can fix something quick. You are not live quite yet, guest, but I'm going to introduce you super fast, super soon. You can see your face here, actually, just briefly. Some amazing technical things here, and then we're going to do this.
How's it been going so far?
I think things have been pretty great. so far. So there we have Jeff, who is in here, and then going to be adding our special guest into the stream too. So we're going into this one, and there you have it, Jan Liebermann from Delphi Digital. Welcome, welcome to the stream as the special guest today.
Thanks for having me. Yeah, excited to be here.
Yeah, we're incredibly excited for you to be here too. And for those of you guys who don't know who Jan Liebermann is, he is, I guess you can introduce yourself, Jan, and the role that you played in Axie Infinity Shards.
Oh, absolutely. I'm co-founder of Delphi Digital, and we actually linked up with the Axie team way back when in 2018. We were looking into different projects and really trying to understand the gaming space, and really were captivated then. And then had the really luxury of working with the team on the governance token, and kind of, you know, working side by side with them in 2019. And then in 2020, we were able to also, you know, help lead the round for the new governance token that's launching. So we're excited to kind of see all of that come to fruition, and know how much hard work the team has been kind of dedicating towards this. So excited to really see it live now.
Yeah, we're also incredibly excited to have you with us, and of course to announce everything that's happening. I know the community is probably quite busy reading up on all the information that's available, but while we have you here, Jan, I'm going to be presenting just super quickly the details of the Axis token, how the token flow is going, and then we can go jump back into this, and then you can maybe explain a little bit more about how you guys are viewing, for example, the community treasury and some of these other things. So just stay tuned, and then we're jumping right back into the presentation mode here, which should be looking like this. All right, so for those of you guys who are still here, of course, I can see that there is an insane amount of hype in the chat. Basically, the way the token will work in the Axie Infinity universe is that there are players, of course, like any other traditional game. And in that game, these players are, of course, they're spending money and they're playing the game. And that's the same thing that's going to be happening in the Axie Infinity game universe. So you can interact with various games, whether that be, for example, land gameplay, there is going to be the battle mode, and there's also going to be other game modes that's going to be arriving over time. In return for playing the game, if you are a good player, if you are so lucky, you can find access tokens. And at that time, you become an access holder. And then you have some choices. So what do you want to do with this access token? So there are various things that you can do. Well, if you want to spend it on in-game stuff, you can do that. We don't put any boundaries on using access token as payment. But one of the main things that we think is most exciting is staking the access token to becoming a governor of the Axie Infinity game and the game universe. So you stake the token, and then that means that you can actually govern the Axie Infinity game universe. And in return for that, the Axie Infinity game universe is going to be putting all the revenue it gets from the game into the Axie Infinity community treasury. And that also means newly issued access tokens for those who are staking at the beginning. So that means that if you are a player of Axie Infinity, you are staking your access tokens, and you also play. So there are demands for playing, for example, every week to claim rewards. So if you play and you claim and you vote on governance votes that are happening, that means that you can claim weekly rewards. That's basically the whole foundation of the economy. So the use cases are, in general, you can vote or participate in governance in the future. You can stake it, and then you can use it for payment. So that's kind of the high level overview. And I guess, Jan, now is a good time for you to kind of come in and say, what do you think about this token economy, and why do you think it's a good fit for a game like Axie?
Be able to buy and sell these assets, and they're not necessarily limited to your game, but also to be able to share in the upside overall. Ed, a comment saying that it might be muted, but
yeah,
oh, sorry. Yeah, so I've spent a great deal of my life playing a lot of games, a big gamer, and so there's something, you know, on one end, it's great to be able to really be able to buy and sell these assets, and I think it makes it a lot easier for people to commit capital, but it's something entirely different where everyone who plays gets to benefit from the growth of the game. And I think it's a really unique, creative way to align a lot of incentives in a way that really makes the sum of the whole greater than the individual parts. I think the token really helps foster, continue to kind of grow that community, reward users, keep users engaged, and really be able to, I think, create a lot of unique incentives that can become really fun once additional features of the game begin to get rolled out.
Yeah, I think the main purpose, of course, of AXS is to align the incentives, as I said. Like, how can we make sure that everyone who is actually adding value to the Axie Infinity game and network has something to say, and that they also benefit from this? So what we've seen is that some of the strengths of the Axie Infinity game and universe is the community, pretty much, and we want to involve them even more. And the AX or the access token is the beginning of that. Now, it's going to take a little bit of time. Like, that's the full disclosure, because what we believe in is that the team has a lot of work left to do. Axie Infinity as a game and universe is not ready for full decentralization yet, but that is the stated goal. We want to have a decentralized game, but that takes a lot of time. So there are some infrastructure issues, and there are various things that will happen. But over time, we want to achieve this goal, and the access token is an instrumental part over that. Jeff, you're receiving some pokes in the chat to smile a little bit. Are you busy working?
Yeah, I'm making sure that everything's going smoothly, which it seems to be. So yeah, maybe I'll pay attention here
Yeah,
for a second.
good to pay a little bit of attention, I think. It's great to see so many people in the chat. And as you said, Aeon, I mean, it's in the middle of the night for you. I must say thank you for I'm not sure if you have been up all night or you woke up for this, but thank you so much for joining, and we're very excited to have Delphi on board to work on the proposal for the staking for the general, like, Axie Infinity token economy. So I guess I can tell a little bit of a story about that, how it started out. So in
Yeah, no.
the oh yeah, sorry.
Sorry, no, I was just gonna say, yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, so I think since early 2018, we actually knew that we needed we were considering a governance token or some kind of token, but it just didn't really make that sense at the time, because there were so many bad tokens. They didn't really have any value in the networks that they were supposed to have value to. They were, like, only payment tokens, that they pretty much nothing. So we waited on that, and then in the middle of 2019, things started to develop for real. So we actually had a proposal when we came to you guys, and then I remember you took a really deep look into it and came with some really good feedback, and that's kind of evolved into the access token economy that we know today.
Yeah, I think in terms of, like, the order of operations, you guys really nailed it in the sense that, like you mentioned, you could have launched a token earlier, and then you probably wouldn't have had as strong of a sticky community. Whereas now you had the real players and everyone who really enjoyed the game to come, build that foundation and really provide that base. And now you get to introduce a token that provides incentives for existing and new users, but it really allowed the strong community to organize around the game and not necessarily around just hoping the token kind of goes up. And so now you get to kind of inject a well-designed token into an already growing community. And I think, it'll kind of really help that spread like wildfire.
Yeah, I think also this opens up for some interesting opportunities for Axie Infinity in terms of like capturing a new audience. So up until now, we've been very focused on the NFT space, and Axie Infinity is still not at a state where we are ready to go fully mainstream. I would say, like, we need some more free to play is probably a big one, and a little bit more work on the infrastructure side. But this is a good start to kind of reach out to a more broader crypto audience. Because, for example, we've seen that with Mana already for Decentraland. People discover Mana, they see the token, for example, going up in price a little bit, and then they discover what's happening under the hood. So incredibly excited to see how this goes, and of course, a little bit more on the details of the launchpad. If you guys want to buy access tokens through the Binance launchpad, you need to own BNB tokens. And then you need to stake them, and then you need to participate in the lottery, and that's when you can be allowed to buy. And I can see Jeff has brought up Puff now too. So, but fear not. If you're not able to buy, you can always earn the token by playing the game eventually. So, Jeff, so how is it going? Is there a lot of hype in the community so far?
Yeah, I think people are excited. So what I want to stress is that, you know, everybody who owns Axies, who's won battles in our alpha application, you know, who owns land, you guys are all getting access tokens, and that those tokens will be claimable at a later date. And the Launchpad event, the way that I see that is that's an opportunity to expand our audience and expand our expand the people who are interested in Axie Infinity to a really broad crypto community. And the great thing about Launchpad is that it ensures that you have a variety of people who are able to get the token at a certain price, rather than, for example, if you just list the token on Uniswap, you know, typically what happens is a bot will come in and, you know, 5x the token anyway, and then you basically have one entity or one bot that basically got all of the cheap tokens. So it's a pretty proven and battle tested distribution strategy. And I think the interesting thing is it's never really been done with a product and a community that actually has traction going for it prior to the Launchpad. So I think this is going to be an awesome experiment. And yeah, I think a lot of people are going to be finding out about Axie in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, and of course we'll be working hard to promote it as well, reaching out to the Binance communities on Telegram, and we have luckily some good we've seen it happen in the past with Sant, how that IO went. So of course our goal is to beat them, and we can only do this with the community's help. So let's see if we have some questions in the chat. There is some question. Can the community buy access tokens right now? No, sorry, there is no way to buy access tokens, until the Launchpad event is over. And you guys do not buy anything called Access or AXS or Axie that's claiming to be the governance token on Uniswap until that time. All the information will be out on our official Twitter page. Please do not get scammed on this, because we've seen already so many people trying to take advantage of the community that we have. There's a question when the snapshot was taken. I think a little bit earlier today.
I have the exact block. If you check the appendix of the Substack article, mm-hmm. You will find the block number. It's block, I think, 11,130,500.
Any other questions? Land gameplay, community alpha, wasn't the goal for end 2020? It says X100 everything. So we have been the internal alpha. The land gameplay has already been internal alpha for some time. So we're testing it. We're quite happy about it. But the community alpha is probably the same stage as the battle game that's out right now. So is the amount of AXS proportional to the amount of land and such? There is a specific calculation there that our CTO has created. So I'm not sure if we're going to be releasing the exact specifics about that, Ramses, but something will come out soon. Does Jan ever sleep? Asks Maki QC.
Now, this is a funny in-between time where it was like 3 a.m, it's an easy decision to stay up. If it's 5 a.m, it's easier to go to bed. And this was right in the sweet spot. So the easier decision here was just an all-nighter.
Yeah. Katakax wants to know, can't we know how it's calculated? Yeah, we might release that calculation a little bit later.
So what I want to kind of clear up about the snapshot is that basically we decided what the parameters of the snapshot would be a couple of weeks ago, 2 to 3 weeks ago. But you know, there's been a lot of work preparing for this, and we want to make sure that the math and the math really makes sense. So we've held off on basically deciding the exact formula, but we have basically picked the parameters or the inputs. So we think that was the right decision, and that's basically what I want to say there.
Yeah, I should also say that there's been some question about SLP. SLP will have a place in the Axie Infinity ecosystem. It is tied to breeding of Axies, so you all know that. People will need SLP still. If there is something that's changing with SLP in the future, we're going to let you guys know. But for now, at least, there is no plan change. Can SLP exchange with access? No, it cannot be exchanged with access unless someone is making an SLP access pair on Uniswap eventually. And I guess that will happen actually as well. What will happen to Luna? Luna has been replaced. The existing Luna holders, those who were holding Luna, the snapshot was taken there too. They will receive the equivalent in access tokens once that is ready. Mm-hmm. Anything else? A lot of questions here. Raffle or giveaway, SLP to $1. I don't know about that. Maybe. I mean, we've seen SLP hype going on too. So if there is, did the AXS or Access private sale already occur? Yes, it did, EV. And Delphi Digital actually led that round. That's also one of the reasons why Jan Lieberman is in the chat with us. So what happened there is that Delphi, they were originally contracted to do work on the token. And I think the more they started doing research into Axie, the more they just realized that something unique is happening here. But I guess maybe you can say a little bit more about that, Jan. What happened there?
So, originally we kind of found out about you guys in 2018, but we kept in contact and there wasn't anything really formal to kind of establish there. And then at the time of the token design, it was something we realized, you know, we were going to purchase internally, but it was before we had the fund. So it was funny. We were designing it thinking like, yeah, this would be really cool to invest in, but we just didn't have the capability at the time because the fund wasn't live yet. And then the launch of the fund kind of coincided with the round. So the timing worked out there really well, where it was after seeing how, you know, everything was coming together, it was definitely something we wanted to invest in. And then timing worked out where we just had the capability to do it afterwards. And we jumped all over and took as much as we can.
Yeah. So that's also some good news for everyone who has access tokens, all the players. The demand for access has been quite incredible. So we are, of course, very excited to see how this launch will go. And thank you for everyone who likes the Dalmatian dog behind here. It looks like she is dreaming. Her tail is wagging a little bit. There was a question from Ramses about circulating market cap of the Luna token. The circulating market cap was one thing, but the if you view the contract, it was always a lot higher than the circulating market cap for Luna. So let's see, when will access be unlocked? So the first thing that's going to happen now is that tomorrow, the launchpad event is starting tomorrow. And that means that from that time, you can stake your BNB. After that, there's this 9 year, not 9 year, that would be a little bit long. I believe it's until the 3rd of November where you can stake and a snapshot will be taken. Those who are lucky, they will win the lottery draw and they can buy access tokens for 0.1 or what is that, 10 cents per access. And after that, we can't say anything about listing because that's some regulatory stuff, but I'm quite confident that the access will be listed on Binance. When was the cutoff date? New user, what cutoff date for snapshot? Yeah, the cutoff date was
the snapshot was taken today. Yeah. I posted the block.
Yep. Nerf Rimp. Says XBTUSD. We'll see.
Rimp has been nerfed quite a lot, actually. The best beasts are not using Rimp anymore.
Mm-hmm. So there's a question about distributions. When owners distribution of axes or access tokens, the access token will get distributed to those who own it after the token is available for trading. And I should also say, this is an important piece of information that I think I should have said a little bit sooner. That a portion, like everyone is getting a set amount of access tokens. Some of these access tokens will be unlocked immediately, and some of them will be unlocked over time. And this is because when we saw, for example, what happened with the Uni token, it is our belief that people don't actually recognize or realize how powerful the Uni token is, for example. So they get it and they sell it immediately. And in time, that might not be such a good experience because the uni token, in my opinion, I'm a uni bull, and I am also an access bull. So I that's why we think it's fair for some tokens to be unlocked and some tokens to be unlocked over time. Yes, you can go to sleep, Ramses. Don't worry about it. This is the announcement stream. Now everyone has all the information to make the choices that they want. So yeah. When is Ronan coming? Says Kansashuru. Ronan is coming very soon. If you check the white paper at whitepaper.axieinfinity.com, you can see the upcoming the roadmap. Will there be a Christmas event? No comment about that yet. Any breeding events? No comment. Will land items consider for access airdrops? Only Axie land has been considered for airdrop. Or, well, it's not an airdrop. They worked for it. I should say that clearly. Legacy X, we'll get back to that later, BP. Okay. I think we might probably going to close off the stream pretty soon. Maybe we'll give it about 10 minutes with some more questions, unless you guys have something else you want to talk about, Jeff and Jan.
I'm seeing a lot of questions. The same question is, will land item holders be taken into account? And I don't believe so. Because the problem with land items is that it's very difficult to value them. With land, it's, you know, we can use the chest price, for example, as some kind of base indicator. So I can confirm with the engineers, but
yeah,
and that's all. Yeah.
From what I can understand, at least there will be no items drops, or the items were not counted in that. No rewards for plushies, unfortunately. Items came from chests. Yes, that's right. They did. Rasterize. So I think maybe we have one piece of info that we haven't actually talked about yet. Maybe, Jan, you want to talk a little bit about the staking yields and that kind of stuff?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, so I'm going to take it up on stream, take it up the proposal here. So there we go. I'm not sure if you have it up on your screen too.
I'm actually following the stream on another screen, so indirectly, and now I do.
Great. Yeah, so you even have I'm going to make you a little bit bigger here. Hello. All right, so this is a part of the proposal from Delphi Digital. So the having designed the core structure, I guess you can talk a little bit about this if you want. You don't have to read everything, but yeah.
Absolutely. So the goal was to the token, you know, has a few functions, and in terms of what we really wanted to incentivize was player adoption and rewarding users that are actually playing. So you can have those that want to just play, and so there's a play to earn feature where the amount you earn is a function of how much you play, obviously with limitation. And then at the same time, there's a staking feature where if you play and stake and fulfill certain criteria, then you can also earn a share of those rewards. And the way that these rewards are sourced, so what happens is a portion of the funds get sent to the community treasury, and the community treasury is basically the ultimate pot where a lot of the excess distributions kind of happen. You can kind of think of that as the DAO treasury and the balance sheet of Axie and what it can deploy. And so initially, we kind of subsidized a lot of the yield through issuance, and the way that happens is just basically you can see the light blue bars and how those decline over time. And the idea there is as the game kind of continues to grow and more users come in, a portion of all of the fees and all of the in-game spend is added into this community pot. And so the goal is, because the community pot is also seeded with the token, is to create a situation where the token can gain value over time and effectively allow users to kind of continue to grow their yield. And so it's great because it's a scenario where if you have whales or large players kind of moving in and hoarding assets and you know, spending a lot of money in the game, it doesn't necessarily take away from the experience of the of smaller players, because as token holders, they're effectively able to get access to all of those fees. And so it's a great way to encourage user growth in all ways, because everyone kind of benefits from new users coming into the game and playing, and it's an environment where you can actually make decent yields from playing and also from staking. I think it's definitely a model that I think we'll see other games potentially take, you know, to try, because I do have a lot of confidence in how this is going to work out. And so the idea here is that you actually will get pretty sizable yields. And I think also the timing of the launch of the token is really fortunate in the sense that we're past that kind of yield farming craze. And so now it's not about kind of mercenary capital or players that just want to move from place to place and generate the highest yield. But now it kind of comes down to fundamental and sustainable yields. And that's where I think games and platforms that can support that will really excel, which, you know, Axie certainly falls in that category.
Yeah, I think just to kind of add on a little bit to what you were saying is that basically what we're trying to say here is that a sustainable growth can only happen over time in a gaming ecosystem. There are a few factors that need to be here. So the first one is, of course, that the game has to be fun. So people need to come into the game. They need to feel comfortable, for example, spending money on things inside that don't necessarily give a direct yield. For example, like the revenue has to come from somewhere. That's kind of one of the principles. And then there is also the fact that the people who are staking the AXS, they have to be able to get some rewards. And initially, there might not be too much revenue flowing into the game, because the game needs a little bit of time to grow, right? So we are setting ourselves up for a growth phase that can take several years, because the infrastructure is so early still inside in the crypto economy. So that could take over several years. So that means that it's going to be subsidized by the issuance of access tokens to those who are staking and contributing value to the network. And over time, as that issuance goes down, there will be more revenue coming in, which is kind of reflecting how the game should grow. So we are very excited about this token economy, and I think it's going to set the standard for future games, or pretty much everyone who is trying to build a play-to-earn game in the future, because the revenue has to come from somewhere. And if you aren't willing to share it with the users who are playing your game, well, then why are you even building a blockchain game? Is that even a blockchain game? Not in our opinion.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. And I don't know, have you guys mentioned anything about Action Score? Or were we just...
Yeah, no, I did not do that. You can talk about the Axie Score.
Yeah, so in terms of, you know, functionality and innovative ways to kind of incorporate the token, one of the things we all worked together on was this idea of an Axie score. And so the score is basically a function of how much you stake and how long you stake it for. And what your score determines is the probability of you winning. You know, there will be different distributions. Part of it could be financial distributions from excess funds in the DAO pool, or also limited edition axes or kind of certain items that aren't really readily available. And so what your axie score kind of does for you is it increases your probability of winning those items. But, you know, by no means are you guaranteed if you have a huge one, but you certainly have better odds. And so we kind of the formula is a bit specifically designed to allow those users who want to, so because the function of time and quantity, users who want to really boost their Axie score early on can buy a lot and try and play catch up a bit that way. But ultimately, you do need to be a long-term aligned with the platform to really improve your score and kind of build on that leaderboard. And we think there's a lot of ways we can continue to kind of expand what that score does and adding different functionality within the community.
Yeah, the access score is a critical piece of how we can reward those in the community who are actually giving that extra effort and playing the game. So when I say people are playing and they're voting, these two things, they add to that combined Axi score, which will be used to calculate the rewards at the end of the week. So over time, if you are doing various things, you, and also, of course, the longer you stake, the higher your Axi score is. So this is a very interesting way of doing it. At least that's what we think. So over time, of course, I should say that some things will probably be iterated on. We are not married to everything here. I think that's very important to say. For those of you who have been in the Axi community for some time, you know that we change things if we see that is needed. So that's a full disclaimer here. We will change things if we see that it is needed for the long-term growth of the game. And that's a right that we reserve, basically. And I think that we have deserved that right too, over delivering over several years. So that's why we don't think the game is ready for full decentralization yet. But hopefully in the future it will be. When merch store? Coming soon, probably. We know there's a lot of hype for plushies. All right, Jeff, how's it going? Falling asleep over there, or?
Going well. That, you know, there's a lot of stuff that we fixing a link. Just doing some maintenance. But yeah, things seem to be going pretty smoothly. Yeah, I'm really excited. So yeah, definitely. We just dream just came true for me. Where CZ. Tweeted about Axi. Actually, it might be the second time, but here he's kind of like more explicitly acknowledging it. So basically, you know, what I want to say is that we have such a strong community that, you know, we could have done a very successful sale, just using our current resources, right? The goal of this Binance event is not to raise funds. So, to be honest, we could have raised a lot more doing something else, right? The goal is to expose Axi to a really broad audience, right? People always say, like, Axi is the best game. Axi puts up the best numbers. Why doesn't everyone in crypto know about it, right? And that's one of the things that we wanted to address with this, is that we want to be on the radar squarely for everybody. What's happening here is so special, but people just won't wake up to it. It would take a lot longer for people to wake up to it if we didn't have a partner like Binance on board. Binance is going to be a great way for us to expand and strengthen the community. So that's the main reason, I think, from our end, why we chose to go this route.
Yeah, that's very good point there. I think it's extremely excited to work with Binance here, and their reach is. Of course, one of the biggest in crypto, if not the biggest. But I'm sure there will... we'll see a lot of interesting things happening in the coming weeks, I believe. SLP on Binance? That's probably not going to happen. I don't think so. But I'm never going to say never, but you never know. Did we have...
Yeah, sorry if I seem serious. I'm very excited. I was just, you know, I'm working. I'm multitasking, I guess. You could say. So
the question from Igor Kali Gamer is that when can we get access from playing the game? That will be coming very soon. We are expecting a full launch of the entire staking and the entire gaming ecosystem early on next year. So if you check the roadmap on Axie Infinity, the white paper, you can see that that's where we have committed to specific quarterly dates. This one is nice. The team is killing it. I can already see my boy playing this in 10 years. The coolest kid in school will be measured by their Axie collection. That's right. That's all I have to say about that. And that's also, I guess, why Delphi are the coolest kids. Coolest funds, they own the Mystic Axies. So maybe you want to say a little bit about that choice, Jan?
No, we always wanted to, because like we have some that we bought just to kind of play, and they weren't really massive investments in that respect, but we definitely wanted to really deploy into some that we thought made a lot of sense. So, you know, we had some friends that are one specifically that was really plugged into the game, and had Jeff help us as well to really figure out what made sense. And so it wasn't hard to decide to spend that much on them just based on your confidence. It was more so just figuring out exactly where we want it allocated. And so, yeah, we're excited to kind of see how both, you know, their abilities kind of level up over time and just seeing how the market develops and kind of where the value starts to grow. But and also just to battle with them as well.
Yeah, I mean, I love this, and I love to see also we've seen, for example, even Pokemon cards going up lately. I mean, collectibles as an asset class in general are just blowing up like crazy. And of course,
I'm
we think,
actually,
yeah, yeah,
yeah, I'm
definitely.
actually thinking of doing like some kind of social experiment where I try and sell my Charizard. I have a Shadowless Charizard apparently. I'm trying to see if I can sell it on Uniswap, but it's like really difficult. Like there are a lot of issues with physical collectibles, you know, getting them graded, and then obviously it's just not trustless, right? So, I might go through that process. Another thing that I want to say to the community is that, you know, you guys know about Delphi now that they came in and made these big purchases. The Delphi have believed in us since we had maybe 20 daily active users on chain, right? So these guys, you know, they really have a great research process, and I think they've been amazing, amazing friends and amazing the partners. And I think you know, having them on board and, you know, kind of join the Axie community, I think that's going to be really awesome.
Yeah,
Really appreciate the kind words.
for sure, I agree there. I think rounding off today, I just want to say make sure to follow us all on Twitter, the official Axie Infinity Twitter. Join us on Discord, follow us on YouTube, all that kind of stuff. And stay tuned for more information in the coming weeks about the launch of the Axie Infinity shards. Yeah, just in general, a lot of cool stuff is happening. And I think that's it for me. Do you guys want to say something before we round it off? Maybe we'll start with you, Jan.
No, just yeah, really, really excited to be here. Excited to kind of watch this play out, and yeah, the community here is insane. Just it's not just like the size, but also the engagement, the activity, and it's easily the best Discord group, you know, that I found in the space. And so you guys have done a really good job, and you know, it's a testament to the team and the quality of the game, and you know, the fact that you guys kind of keep delivering. So yeah, excited to kind of just be on board and watch this all grow.
What about you, Jeff? Anything final to say?
Yes, today is for you. Today is a celebration. Congrats on becoming access holders. And yeah, I think the community is going to grow a lot in the coming days. So yeah, please help us spread the word. You guys, every single one of you with a Discord, with a Twitter, you know, you can do a lot to help the ecosystem. I think that's, you know, one of the things that's really made Axie work and what's made it special. So there's going to be a lot of new players coming in, asking a lot of questions. Please be nice to them. You know, please help them. Please help us spread the news on Twitter, social media. Yeah, you know, thank you, thank you. We couldn't have gotten here without you. Yeah, I think this is just the beginning of the beginning.
Great. Well said, Jeff. And thank you to everyone who's joined us today. We're probably going to do more team streams as well in the coming months. So stay tuned. All right. Bye, guys.